Hi signs, how are you guys doing? So Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, we are in the Leo season. New moon in Leo is happening, full moon in Aquarius is happening, and I'm super excited. I'm using the Lenormand. I'm doing your what's coming up for you by September, in September, and the upcoming week going forward in August, right? So I'm doing a collective reading for the fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, and I'm going to pull out the clarifiers as to what you need to see, okay? So do watch. All my information is in the description box, and I send you so much of love and light. If you have not liked and subscribed to the channel, please do. I would really appreciate. Hey, my new joiners, thank you for being here. And my old joiners, thank you for being here. I like the community growing, which is growing slowly, but yeah, I'm happy. And do follow us on Twitter or on Instagram. You can forward all of this. I'm going to timestamp the reading. Okay. So for my fire signs, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, what do we need to see? So I'm going to pull out the Lenormand cards for you, or three cards spread. Okay. Wherein we talk about your core, the core energy. We're going to talk about the block and the advice and outcome. And then I'm going to clarify it. Okay. So they asked me to stop. Show me the message. I take the assistance of my masters, guides who are here with me, my clearly. But show me the message, blueberry, that I need to see for my fire signs. What do we need to see for the fire signs? They're all about strength. They're all about that deep understanding, knowing that they can make it, but a little aggressive in their approach at times they are. So let's see. What do we need to see for the fire signs? Energy. I know some of you are Whitney Houston fans. I'm hearing those songs from Bodyguard. If you are, this reading is definitely having a message for you. So whenever the title attracts you, the reading has something for you, because it is a timeless kind of reading, right? Oh, we have a 10. Okay, J, a letter J. I'm going to explain this to you in a while. A letter J could mean something to you, may not. Okay, so let's see, what do we need to see going forward? So this is warning. This is some kind of inner knowing. Your intuition is really talking, telling you. Yep. Regard to, I'll explain this too in a while. Okay, letter K may mean something to you, may not. This is about four. This is about a certain structure. Could be about a relationship, could be about the home front, family, any dynamic equation, single, dating, committed, you know, in a relationship, complicated kind of vibe. This is kind of complicated. Okay, but the house is really about the safety. It's about, you know, the kind of privacy you've been asking for, wanting for, the conservation you want to maintain, but your intuition is telling you something else. So this is one block in the head that maybe you're not seeing something that you should see. So let's see what's the final card. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Ooh, 28. Letter A may mean something to you, may not. You've got two tens on board, which is like that big change happening, okay? And you're not seeing it. It is about, I think it's so to do about the temptation that you're not watching right now, and I feel you should watch, because you know, with the scythe here, as we see, the scythe is, as I said, you know, it's all about the confusion which is around a certain relationship, because your intuition is telling you something else, your heart, your mind is telling you something else, and you don't know as to which way to go to right now. You're at the two of swords kind of energy. You're not even sure as to whether this would work the way, you know, I was thinking it would, because somewhere down the line it has a different connotation. So they say whatever happens, it happens for a reason. This could be about you met somebody you felt attracted to, you felt connected to instantaneously, but you know what, maybe this was not meant to be. So this is like a warning bell to you. Let me just say that out loud, okay? Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, maybe you are in a relationship, something of this nature can come to you, okay? So just make sure that you see that what is being cut around, what is being offered to you, you know. So there is a difficult decision that you need to break. Maybe you need to break from somebody, you need to take a break from somebody so that you can think more clearly, you can see the greener side of life as well. And the next card really changes the whole meaning in Lenormand, really. So we have the house, which is about security, which is about patterns, which is about tradition, which is about so much to do with you know, privacy, security and all of that. So honestly, this is about, this is like the Four of Wands kind of energy, wherein, you know, this talks about those kind of mindsets that cannot be altered somewhere down the line. That's also one side to it, you know. In this particular aspect, that's what I see. You want peace at home, you want peace in a relationship, you want the best in a relationship, right? You don't want people to be selfish or manipulative. You want people who are honest, who are warm, who are gentle, who are kind, you know, and who are ready to offer you the kind of love they have to offer. The nature of that relationship and the journey of that relationship is always positive. So, and the house basically is built on strong you know, foundation, on strong structures. With the man here, he really wants to communicate. The energy really wants to communicate, talk, tell you how they feel. Maybe something was not right in the past. That's how I see this, honestly. We'll use the right away to clarify it. But something in the past was not right, and your intuition is really telling you, for some who are already in a relationship and a gamut of such, and somebody are receiving a warning that something like this can come to you. So use your inner compass, okay? But whoever offers you a lot of security, stability, all of that, make sure that you use your intuition. Let your intuition guide you through and take you through, so that you can cut across the veils, you know, you can transform and you can have more mental clarity. So let's see, what is the Rider really suggesting? What do we need to see Michael in regard to this? What is it? Because with the house here, you know what I see, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, it is about certain changes that need to come around in a relationship that is already existing, or the one which is coming would need certain alterations, would need certain changes. Because, you know, you have to use the right key to open the lock. You cannot put in the keys all the time, different keys. If it's not meant to be, it is not going to happen, right? So they asked me to stop. Show the messages for the side. So what do we need to see for the side? So I'm going to pull out three clarifiers. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. What is the side about, Michael? Too many. What is the side about? Okay, so this also. This is Four of Cups. Okay, so now we have the Tower that flipped prior. So Tower is not always bad, but the Tower is really about that light that is going to strike, and maybe it's like that pre-information that is being given to you. If you see this reading, they're saying the Divine is offering you help. The Divine is really offering you help. You need to accept it. You need to understand that, you know, whatever happens, happens for good. You should not question it that much, but yes, you should know that if your intuition is telling you something, you should not ignore it. You should just not ignore it. You should pay attention to it, because that will bring about the structural security, safety that you were so longing for. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy. Absolutely. I mean, this king is strong. This king is stable. This king is secure. This king is balanced. This king is someone who knows his worth. You know, this king is someone who's seen and made it all, you know. He's got luck by his side. He believes in keeping things in balance. So this is a lot to do with the structure of a relationship. What is this house about? What do we need to see with the site in the house? The Moon, yeah, there are certain things that you don't know right now. They're not telling you. This is more like a Piscean energy for me. The Moon for me is that. So there are things that you don't know, and it's like one foot in, one foot out kind of vibe. You know, at times they want to be with you, at times they don't want to be with you. Could be you as well. You know, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, those who are watching, please use your inner compass, okay? So when the reading, you know, at times we kind of miss it out. So just use your inner compass. So with this, really, with the moon, I think what you need to really see is that, you know, you need to listen to both your head and your heart. Do not ignore it. And by the full moon in Aquarius, you would know largely as to how, what things are going to pan out. But this reading would be till the first week of September. So yeah, whenever you see this, it has something for you. Once you will start paying attention to what... Sorry, Pani, I had to take water. So once you start paying attention to what your head and heart are telling you, once you are able to cut across things that are not seen to you, but you are able to see them somehow, with the tower and the divine kind of working with you, your masters telling you, sending you signs, because you don't want to repeat those patterns again. You would move towards calmer waters. You would be more easy with you. You would be more easy with the person in question. And you would make peace with the whole thing. Queen of Pentacles, yeah. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy. So this is, and this is like, ooh, very strong connection, guys. When, you know, we have the same energy around, it is about that strong viability. It is about that strong connection that you guys already have, or something very strong is coming to you. And you just need to cut across maybe a certain mindset, which is your kind of block. Maybe now that I see that, this could be your block as well. Honestly, that you want certain things a certain way. So you will have to drop those if you want growth, if you want this connection to work, if you want this connection to reach abundance or get abundance that it deserves. You will have to give it that opportunity. Okay, and you'll have to cut the right things the right way. Because maybe, you know, cross watchers, as I said, you know, take it the way it's resonating. Maybe you're not accepting the help that the divine is giving you. Maybe you're not seeing that. That is why the tower struck, so that you can get woke. Okay? Or this could be that the person that you're thinking about is going through the same. The A is really about this gentleman, this energy, masculine energy that we see is really about Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. So this is about someone watching you, stalking you, thinking about you, want to reach out to you, want to say things to you. Simple. It is about being very clear, being very forthright, saying things the way they are, like, you know, blunt, clear. So, of course, the etiquettes are in place, but they just want to tell you there, and they're watching you. They're really watching you right now. Because there's this transformation, you know, which is happening. There is this change which is happening. With the death that we have here, it is not a bad card, okay? Death is about the transformation, that new beginning that you'll be making. So this is like that warning bell with the scythe, as I said initially. For some of you, that you need to change a certain mindset that you have. And once you do that, you transform, you would be super happy when I say that. Because we have a King of Pentacles, we have Queen of Pentacles here, which is so fab. And you got 2 tens here. See? So you got the 10 of Cups. So emotional well-being would be restored. You will get what you're really asking for. You just have to continue working on yourself, or on the connection you're asking about. You just need to know what you need to cut out. You need to know what you need to have. So basically, you need more mental clarity as of now in question, or the person you're thinking, asking about, needs that kind of mental clarity. And once that happens, this connection is super rocking, and it's going to be wonderful going forward. And I hope this resonates. And if this resonates, do give us a like and subscribe. I'm going to pull out a fairy oracle for you, because the fairies are with me. And so let's see what we need to see. What do we need to see for Aries, Leo, Sagittarius? We have opportunity knocks. Isn't that amazing? So it's about someone reaching out to you and telling you, you know what? I'm right here, honey. You're not seeing. And they're saying, go for it. Make those changes. Make that little effort, okay? If you're a cross watcher. Bring about that change in you. Or if this is resonating with you, is your Sagittarius, go for it. Make that change. Transform with the depth. The tower has struck. The divine is helping you. It's a fabulous connection. It's a fabulous, fabulous connection that will bring about a lot of emotional stability and a lot of strength to you as well. So this is what I have for you, my Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. And I shall see you the next time at Eternity. Sending you so much of love. Bye.